sacramental but not consummated.
So these you need not go, you have to go to the Holy Father only.
This cannot be done at the diocesan level.
But one thing at the diocesan level is the Pauline privilege, that by the interpolation can be dissolved at the diocesan level.
Here again, it is a non-sacramental marriage, but one party gets baptism, because of that marriage is a problem. So the law allows the baptized party to contract a new marriage because he received baptism. We should not impose celibacy on him because the other party is unwilling to leave. That is Pauline privilege. So these three cases are real marriages. Two cases not sacramental marriage, but one case sacramental but not consummated. So the Holy Father can dissolve. This is called dissolution of an existing bond. Declaration of the fact that there was no bond. That is the difference between nullity and dissolution. Nullity and dissolution.
Dissolution of
an
active bond.
Active.
Existing.
Yeah. Existing bond. Yeah. Dissolution of a valid marriage. One is valid non-sacramental marriage. Valid sacramental marriage but not consummated marriage. Sacramental marriage, not consummated marriage. Some people were hoping that the Holy Father will give the power to the bishops to break the non-consummated marriages, but still it has not taken place. It is by virtue of the vicarious power, petrine power, still it is reserved to the Roman Pontiff, Roman Pontiff. Okay. We spoke of that in the context of even for another. Suppose one of you is very holy, Calcutta priest coming from there. I can ask for a respite for you. I write to the Holy See, he is such a good student in my class. So kindly grant him the title Monsignor. I can get a respite even without your knowledge. But you can renounce the privilege, that is afterwards. But when I get the title Monsignor, it is still valid for you. A rescript can be obtained even for another without that person's consent. A person can renounce the privilege. That is another matter. We will study about it later. That's what? Even without the other person's consent. Even without the other person's consent. Okay.
What is intention here for other without the consent of the other person?
Yeah.
What is intention of getting without the consent of the
other? I am doing good. No, rescript is always favor. Rescript is always a favor. The Holy See itself sees, oh, so many people are coming to Shivajinagar Basilica. So they want to give extra graces there, mean extra indulgences there. They don't feel it, they don't ask for it, they are granting it. Good, well and good, without your consent also it can be given.
For others it may not become a favor or a recipient.
Yeah?
For others, those who are not good with him or anything. For you it may be good.
Yeah.
That's why you get the...
Yes. That's why later on we are going to study about renouncing the rescripts. Renouncing the rescripts. If anybody can renounce any rescript, especially privilege, which is granted for his own personal self, that we will study. We can get it. That's what. What is favorable can be obtained. If the person concerned thinks it is not favorable to me, Once I called a Monsignor, I have to behave like Monsignor. I can't go for a walk like this freely. So he doesn't want it, he can renounce. He can renounce. But I can obtain for him like that. Okay. We go to the next canon. On respect, canon 62. This we have already studied, still they have once again repeating it for the sake of people who say no, it is too fast for all the canons. Once again they are repeating. For me the repetition is useless. You know when is an administrative act effective. So when you read that you will know this we know father already why they got put here, you will think like that. A rescript in which there is no executor, that means forma graciosa rescript, has effect from the moment the document was issued. Very clear for us, singular administrative acts in which there is no executor is effective when it is communicated to the person. If it is forma graciosa, then the second part, the others have effect, that means commissorial rescripts have effect from the moment of execution. Very simple. Very simple. When they are executed. Some when they are communicated, some when they are executed. When they are executed. Anybody doesn't understand, then I have to make an examination of conscience about the teaching. Okay, we go to canon 63. I have already indicated it. One class also explained both the words. Now let us see. We said that rescript is generally, normally in response to the petition. Most of the time, what moves the competent authority? It is the petition. You come and say, Father, my brother is very serious, went with an accident. He wants to see me, so I have to be with him 3 days. Going on shedding tears. Okay, Father, what is important is you are being with your brother during his moment of tragedy, suffering. So now you go there, and then brother means somebody in the village brought in the petition you have interpreted. But your tears come even if you cut onions, your tears come. So I am duped by it all. We said permission, no? Permission also we apply the principle of respect, no? Respect. So you go there and come. After 1 week I come to know that you have really cheated toward the lies, fraud. Some things you said, accident, everything is okay. But then some things you did not say. Somebody in the family, I don't know, you have a large extended family of 1,000 people. I said family means like this. So you are sometimes leaving unsaid some things. Sometimes you say some things to cheat the people. So my permission depended on that. I did not give motapraprya permission. Motapraprya permission. Irrespective of the reasons advanced against you. So this particular canon says, how can a rescript become invalid? Because of lies, because of not telling the essentials. So we see here, first about subruption. Subruption can make a rescript invalid. Subruption. The meaning is given in the canon itself. What is it? Withholding the truth. Withholding the truth. withholding that fruit. The petitioner has to give what is essential, isn't it? He withholds the truth, doesn't say everything. It doesn't mean the petitioner has to write an essay of 10 pages to get a permission, not at all. Sometimes he may write 10 pages, but what is necessary you may fail to mention. Sometimes he may write only one page, what is necessary is already contained there. So you withhold the truth. When you withhold the truth, because there is what is essential is not there, then the rescript becomes invalid, because rescript is dependent on the facts mentioned in your petition. That's why the canon here, look at it, says renders a rescript invalid if the request does not express what must be expressed for validity. It does not express what is required to be expressed. What is required to be expressed? Expressed for validity. So, the petitioner does not express what is required to be expressed for validity. What is required to be expressed for validity? How do you know what is required? So the canon itself says, we know it from law, style and practice. Three words are used. Sometimes law itself says what must be expressed. Sometimes the style, sometimes the practice. Law, style and practice will tell us what is required to be expressed. What is required to be expressed. For example, somebody who procures an abortion before ordination, he becomes irregular. He becomes irregular for receiving the ordination. So only the Holy See can dispense him from that irregularity. The law itself says, how many abortions did he procure? The number also must be mentioned, otherwise it is invalid. He simply says, I procured abortion. When he procured three abortions, suppose one abortion, then it is invalid, because law says. Then two other words are used, style. Normally you have to tell the essentials. Practice, you have to tell. Law, style and practice. From that we know what is essential. For example, you know, in the case of confession, somebody comes and tells, Father, I stole a rope, please forgive me. He is telling only rope, but the cow was tied in the rope and the calf followed, but what he held in the hand was only rope. He told the truth only, but he did not tell that he stole the cow and that calf. He only said, I stole the rope. With the rope came the cow and the calf. This is an excellent example of subraption. Subraption will make the rescript invalid. Invalid. There is the exceptive clause. If the rescript is given motu proprio, there is no problem. Motu proprio means irrespective of your reasons. That's why the exceptive clause is given. Okay, we have the faith, then we will continue. Yeah, okay.